After crossing the Russian border, I went to the Altai Mountains in the evening. First on the Chuisky Tract to the northwest, via Tashanta, Koch Agash, Aktash and Gorno-Altaysk to Barnaul. And then south again in the direction of Rubtsovsk near the Kazakh border. There were no crossroads to drive. The contrast to Mongolia could not be greater. Here are water, trees and birds. This can also be seen in the satellite image. At lower corner, on the right, Mongolia, in the middle, the Russian Altai. Because of the summer holidays, it was not so easy to find an accommodation. On a campground, it worked then. And because the restaurants were already closed, the hospitable neighbors started a barbecue again. The Altai, a really great landscape. On the way, a monument for the builders of the road. With a great view over the Chuya, a tributary of the Katun River. Not so far anymore to Berlin, on a direct way. Years-old rock drawings show that this area was inhabited a long time ago. In Gorno-Altaysk, I had a funny evening with a group of young Russian snowboarders. And the next evening I found a note from a young Swede under the Viper. But unfortunately he wanted to go towards the Mongolian border from where I just came. Towards Barnaul, the landscape became flatter and greener.
Continue straight, then slight left.
Also in Barnaul itself, thunderstorms at the beginning.
Destination is on the right.
On the last day in Russia, a mix of sun and thunderstorm. For this thunderstorm, I stopped at a gas station. With a rooftop box, I was always the highest point on the road. But at some point, it was over and I drove on to Rubtsovsk. Many village streets were also perfect, and the other were being built. Then the exit from Russia at the Kazakh border. Here I met German car tourists for the first time who wanted to go on to the Pamir Highway with their own Unimog.